There are lots of ways you can resize an image within Photoshop, but we're looking at the image size palette, and in this film we're specifically looking at document sizes. We've already made a film about how to do pixel dimensions, which you're looking at here on the screen, and there's a link to it underneath this film. Let's just get rid of that and get our mate Photoshop going. Now, I've already chosen an image to demonstrate this with. This is one I shot last week for the Naked Jam Company, and I love these pictures. They're some of my sort of current favourites, so I'm showing off a bit. Okay, here we are. Let's get out our image size palette. You go into Image, Image Size, click on that, and you've got your image size palette. Up here are the pixel dimensions, which we covered in the other film, and below that are the document sizes. What is meant by a document size? Well, a document is a physical thing. You can hold it in your hand. So with a photograph, with an image rather, we're talking about a photograph, aren't we? We're talking about a print. That is what happens when you turn an image file into a document. You get a print. Easy, isn't it, really? This print is 5 inches wide by 7.5 inches high. Okay, it's a 7.5 by 5. That's a pretty standard image size. There are 6 by 4s and 7 by 5s and all that stuff. But we are looking at a 7.5 by 5. Sorry, I clicked something accidentally there. That's why I got all distracted. Right, image size palette. Let's have a little wander through what the different options are. You have a width option and you have a height option. And next to the width and height, notice there are measurements, or in this case, it's set to centimeters. If we drop down the little arrow here, there are different options of measurement. You can have percentages, inches, centimeters, millimeters, points, pickers, and columns. I've been using Photoshop since the 1990s. I've never used a point, picker, or column in my life for anything. I would imagine there's something to do with the printing industry, the press industry, newspapers, magazines, and things like that. But I've never used them, and as photographers, I don't think we really need to, so don't bother giving it any brain space. Likewise, percentages. I have never used the image size palette to increase or decrease the size of an image by a percentage, but maybe you would if you wanted to use that. You just click on it, you see it's on 100. If you want to increase it by 20%, you just type in 120. And there you go. Now notice that Photoshop also increased the height by 120 at the same time. That's because these two little boxes are linked. I'm going to go back and do what I just did and go back to inches again, because it's easier to demonstrate this with proper measurements. Nope, that's wrong. Hang on, I'm getting this all wrong, aren't I? Let's start again. Right. Image size palette. Inches. Happy days, we're back. Right. This image is 17.867 inches by 11.867 inches. That means it's almost 18 inches across the long edge. That's quite a big print, isn't it? That's that sort of size. That's a lot. By changing the width and height on the left, you can change the size of your image. So let's say we want to change that to 12 inches wide. I'll just type in 12, and you'll notice that the height has changed with it. It now says 7.97. That's made it pretty much a 12 by 8, hasn't it? That's because Photoshop is keeping the aspect ratio, that's the shape of the picture, constant, because this little chain here is being displayed. Let's just undo what I did. The reason that chain is being displayed is because this little box here, constrained proportions, is ticked. If I untick it, that chain disappears, and now if I change the width to 12, you see, the 11 has remained the same. It hasn't changed the height in proportion to it. So if I apply that, all of a sudden, my picture goes really rather square and everything gets a bit tall and thin. It's a bit of a funny shape. Let's undo it. Right, image size palette, here she is. Let's retick constrained proportions and bring back my old mates the inches. Underneath this we have resolution, and next to resolution is another little drop down with the option of pixels per inch or pixels per centimeter. We're working in inches, so I'm going to stick with inches. But what does that mean, 240 pixels per inch? Think of pixels as dots. When you print an image, your printer squirts loads of minute little dots all over the paper, and they're all very, very close together. But you don't see them as dots, you see them as a cohesive whole, as a lovely sharp image, because you're viewing them from over here. If you don't have enough dots per inch, then they're going to be too far apart and your image is going to look all soft and soggy. If you've watched the Pixels film, you'll know that monitors and the internet work on 72 dots per inch because that's all the internet or monitors can display. And so your pictures look lovely and beautifully sharp there. But if you try and print an image at 72 dots per inch, what will happen is you'll end up with something that's all sort of jaggedy and it's broken apart and it's blotchy and it's pixely and it's not very nice at all. So you need to make sure you have plenty of pixels per inch or dots per inch. The best resolution rule of thumb this is for printing would be 300 dots or pixels per inch. That means you've got plenty to have a nice sharp image. I don't know if you noticed, but as I changed that to 300, the file size changed. It says up here it's 54.6 megabytes and then in brackets was 34.9. That's because as we've added some resolution, so the file size has got bigger. And this is really a pretty good way of making your file size bigger. If you were sending something to a photo library, they may have a minimum requirement of 50 or 60 megabytes or something. By increasing the resolution a bit, you are increasing the file size, but you're not losing image quality. Underneath here we have a little tick box called scale styles, I can't speak. Just leave it ticked. I'm not going to tell you what it is, mostly because I have no idea what it is. All I know is that Paul Williams, my printer, who is really, really up on this kind of stuff, said, just tick it, you don't need to know what it is, and the results I get are brilliant. So there we go, leave it ticked, job done. Much the same with resample image. There are different options down here. I use bicubic because, again, Paul said do it. He said you'll get the best results from it, and I do. So there we go. I don't know what the others are. You don't need to know either. All you need to know is what to do to get a great image. So we've got it all set up. We've got our constrained proportions and we've got 300 pixels per inch or dots per inch. Let's change the size of the image and make a print, shall we? Well, that one there is a 7.5 by 5, isn't it? So let's make this one the same. Let's make the width 7.5, and Photoshop has made it almost 5 going the other way. So let's click OK. There you go. It's resized it. File, hit the go button, print. Now I'm only printing on plain ordinary paper because I don't print anything here at all. So I'm just going to go in here, make sure it's set just on photo. There's no point me having it on best photo because it would just look horrid. Click OK, click OK, and that's being whizzed off to my printer. And a 7.5 by 5 inch image will pop out on a piece of A4 paper. If you're using proper inkjet paper and you calibrate your monitor and your printer together, then you should have a really lovely print. I'm not going to, I know that. Right, I'm going to have a cup of tea while that trundles out of the printer. Because as we all know, inkjets take a while, don't they? Knowing Janie, she'll speed this bit up or cut it out altogether, I don't know. There you have it. A 7.5 inch by 5 inch print on a sheet of A4 paper. I put that other print there. There we go. All you've got to do is cut the edges off. Job done. Lovely jubbly. Now, I said it's good for checking an image size as well, didn't I? Because there are other sizes which are not the same aspect ratio as this. For example, 10 by 8 is one of the most popular frame sizes. But if we use, let's just undo what I've done, if we use the image size palette to resize at 10 by 8, it won't work because if I put inches, make that 300 again, and I change that to 10 inches wide, look, it's 6.6 high, not 8. That's because to keep the aspect ratio the same, it has to be 6.6. If I untick constrained proportions and manually enter 8, well, it'll work, but it would be a horrible shape when I apply it. You see what I mean? Again, it's kind of got boxy and a bit taller than it should be. If you want to resize an image to something like 10 by 8, the best way of doing it is to use the crop tool. If I just go out here we go, click it. Look, it's there from when I was practicing, so I'm going to clear that. Right, here we go. We want the width to be 10 inches, so I type in 10 space IN for inches. And then the height, we want it to be 8 space IN for inches, and our resolution, hands up who knows, exactly it's 300 pixels per inch. So we've got enough dots per inch. Now all you have to do is to, you see the cursor's got a little gun sight on it, a little arrow, a little crosshair thing. If I drag that across the image, now notice it doesn't matter where I put the cursor, it's keeping this little row of marching ants here in the aspect ratio of 10 by 8. So if I just drag it straight across and let go, this area has gone dark because it's got to cut that piece off in order to make it 10 by 8. 10 by 8 is a bit of a pain in the neck, so you have a group of people, because it means if they're filling the frame, you're going to cut some of them off at the end. Let's say you don't want naked jam in the middle. Well, you can just drag your crop around a little bit and put it where you want it. I want it about there, like that. Then what you're going to do is press enter, and that will crop the image to 10 by 8. If you want to check it, or someone sent you an image file and they've told you it's 10 by 8, what we've got to do is go into our image, image size, bring up the image size palette, and look in the document size area, convert that to inches, and look, we have a lovely 10 by 8 inch print all ready to go. So there you go, image sizes using the document size area of the image size palette. That's how you use it, and that's what it does. I strongly recommend you go and get your Photoshop out and go and play with it.